And of course, UD coming here is exciting for hometown fans, but it's not necessarily a good thing. James Rutter joining us now with all that little disappointment by them tonight.
Yeah, it's okay, but it's not great for UD. I mean, they have to play an extra game now in the NCAA tournament, and even though their travel lays out really nicely playing in their own backyard of Dayton, and then going on to Columbus if they win that, Eric Elkin was with the team as they saw the news of playing in the first four.
And they will meet the winner of a first four game to be played on Wednesday out of Dayton, Ohio, between Boise State and Dayton.
Well, I don't think anyone saw that coming. Considered by most an 8 or a 9 seed coming into the tournament, Dayton ended up being the last team in the field. And when the Flyers' name came up, one word summed it up.
It's kind of shocking, you know, they got us playing Boise State, but it's not really a big deal with us.
We didn't really expect that. I don't really know exactly what we expected, but that wasn't it.
When the bracket was split, like, it looked kind of weird. I was like, what's going on? And then I realized what happened. And, I mean, just a lot of shock that went on. I think everyone from coaches and all the players were just like,
usually the NCAA tournament, you know, you're on a bus or a plane and you're ready to get shipped off. This is a unique one. Us being in our arena, it's going to be, you know, interesting to see how it all works out. But, you know, back-to-back NCAA tournaments is what it's about.
It means the Flyers have a quick turnaround playing Boise State on Wednesday. But it also means one more game at the arena for the team that went perfect at home this season.
That's fine. I mean, hopefully I can go perfect again. You know, it's just a great environment. Glad to be back in Dayton. I'm sure the city will love it, and it'll just be good for us.
It's very exciting, you know, to come back out to our home fans and, you know, just play one more game in front of them and show them what we could do at home.
I asked Jordan Seibert if this ticks him off a little. He said, quote, kind of, sort of, just adds fuel to the fire. It might be a fire too big for Boise State to put out on Wednesday. Winner advances to play Providence in Columbus on Friday. At Burke's Bar and Restaurant in Yonkers, I'm Eric Elkin.